Hello all, in this short video we will discuss CAN network and database file. As you know, in one vehicle we have multiple issues. Those issues are grouped according to their functionality. This group called as a issue cluster. Here you can see multiple issue clusters like telematics, body control, safety system, powertrain. All these issues are connected with each other through communication bus. Issue clusters are also connected with each other using this communication bus. On this communication bus, millions and millions of signals are used to flow from one issue to other issue or from one cluster to other cluster. OEM need to maintain all database of this signal flowing from one bus. This database contain different information like information regarding communication network, issues, signal, signal periodicity, signal size, their IDs, etc. In this video, we will discuss DBC format of this kind of database. As you know, in vehicle network, multiple issues and issue clusters are connected with each other through communication channel or communication bus. On this bus, millions of signals are used to flow in the form of data packets from one issue to another issue. In development phase, we must have to maintain database which clearly defines list of these signals, signal belong to which message, their message IDs, their orientation in message data block, signal or message periodicity, transmitter and receiver information, size of signal, size of message, etc. We also call this database as a communication matrix. If database is for CAN protocol, then we call it as a CAN matrix. DBC file is nothing but a CAN matrix, which is developed by Vector for their tools like Conui. In short, we can say a CAN DBC file is a text file that contains information for decoding raw CAN bus data to physical values. This is CAN DBC I have created for CAN demo purpose. On left hand side, you will see different entities of this CAN DBC. First one is a networks. Here, you will see the name of network for which this DBC file is created. After that, second container is issues. Here, you will see entire list of issue which belongs to this CAN network. In issue container, you will find different nodes of network. If you expand this node, you will see two more options, that is environmental variable and BMS. This environmental variable is used in different testing and development tools. After that, list of signal. If you click on BMS, this will be the same name which is given to node. Here you will see list of signals which is the part of this node. After issue container, there will be the another container which is network nodes. Here you will find same list of the node which is mentioned in issues, but difference is here you will find all transmit messages, all receive messages, all mapped transmit signal and all mapped receive signal which belongs to this node, which is BMS. If you expand this TX message list, you will find entire list of transmit message which is transmitted by BMS. Same for RX message. Now no any RX message is mapped to this BMS, that's why RX message list is empty. After that, map TX signal. Here are the list of entire signal which is transmitted by BMS. If you observe, this is the same signal which is the part of these messages. For example, in alarm, you will see charge current alarm. Here, charge current alarm. This is the combined list of signal which is part of all these messages. Here in this node, you will see list of transmit messages as well as list of receive messages. Again, mapped TX signals and mapped RX signals. After network node, there is another container which is messages. This is the list of entire messages which is part of this network. Here all messages are listed which is transmitted and received by different issue of this network. After that, signals. Signals, this is the list of entire signal which is the part of this particular network. All these signals are mapped to different transmitter and receive messages. Now we will take one node and see what all information we can get from this DBC. We will take motor control unit. Here, as we know, we can see here all transmit and receive messages. If you double click on node, one dialog box will be open. In this dialog box, the name of node will be there. After that, address. Here, random address or depending upon the requirement, we can mention the address of this particular node. After that, again, list of all transmit signals, list of all receive signals, list of transmit message, then network, name of network to whom node is belong to, then control unit. Control unit is nothing but a name of ECU. Then attributes. Attributes are the information related to this ECU and comments if there are any. Here, if you double click on transmit message, then list of all transmit message will be open. You can see detail of each message by double clicking on that. Here, one dialog box will be open. Here, in definition, same kind of information will be there. Then the node name, name of message, method of transmission like cyclic or on event base, etc. In message, you will see the name of message, type of CAN, ID, its length, transmitter, who is the transmitter of this message, again text method, that is cyclic and cycle time, and list of attributes. Here no attributes is listed, that's why this field is empty. Similarly, you can check particular signal also. Here same kind of information about signal will be there. Definition of signal, here one more information about signal you can see is the start bit. Start bit is 60, that means this signal will start at bit 60. In message, the information of message is given to whom signal is belong to. In signal, details about a signal is given, like length of signal, byte order, which is Intel or Motorola format. Here you can say little endian or big endian. Unit of signal. As we know, on signal we send different parameters like voltage, speed, current, etc. So if you are sending particular information like voltage, then unit will be the volt. You can send different types of values over the CAN. So you can define the type of value in this section. After that, factor and offset. Factor is nothing but a multiplier. Factor is nothing but a multiplier, which is used to convert a raw signal value to a physical value. And offset, again, offset will be the added or deleted from the received signal or received value. Here will be the minimum value of the signal and maximum value of the signal. After that, next option is a receiver. In receiver, you will find receiver node name. After that, value description. In value description, you can give a particular description for a particular value. For example, if our signal is 1 bit, then we can send 0 or 1. Then in this case, you can give value description for 0 as off and value description for 1 as on. After that, attributes. There is nothing in attribute and comments. Again, from below list of messages and signal, you can find more information about messages and signals. For example, we can take this message, vehicle control general information. If you double click on this message, you will see this dialog box. Here in definition, same kind of information like name of message, CAN type, ID, length, etc. In signals, you will see list of entire signal which is the part of this message. In this list, you can see start bit of each signal, length of each signal, and its orientation, whether it is little endian or big endian, or you can say Intel format or Motorola format, and value type of the signal. In transmitter, you will see who is the transmitter of this message. Again, in receiver, you will see who is the receiver of this message. In layout, pictorial format of this message you can see. In this layout, orientation of each signal you can find easily. For example, motor operation mode. If you go into signal, you can see motor control operation. Its length is two bits and start bit is the second bit. In layout, you can correlate it. On second bit, you will find motor operation mode, and as it is 2 bit long, these 2 bits are allocated for motor operation mode. After that, attributes. Attributes is nothing but different information or more information you can find out from this, for example, cyclic time. And in comment, if there are any comment, you can mention over here. This is small introduction about CanDBC file. We will see more information about CanDBC file in coming videos. Thank you.